Alright, here we are. We're having our first day of outside summer weather. I have to put my hand up. This is nice, man. I had all kinds of thoughts going through my mind of what I was going to say. Rebut, my experience has been once I press the record button, all of a sudden, the relaxed mode flows right in. The relaxed mode. So we'll rest in our presence. And we'll wait for the words. Wait for the manifestation of the words. We'll soak up the sunshine. Balance our inner ear. In our outer ears. Relish. Pickles. Mayonnaise. Health food. Fresh vegetables. Fresh fruits. Whole grains. All natural goat's milk. Wow. The goat's milk. Revelation knowledge is entering in. Vedic revelation knowledge. So, when we issue out the Eternal Life CNN Spurlock technology, we'll be able to upload our brains onto the recording monitors, and we'll be able to read each other's thoughts. We'll hear, listen to our inner ear speak. That's arriving soon. It's 12:24 p.m. Pacific Standard Time. We're in the Oregon State. Springfield, Oregon. Springfield is just right across from Eugene. Eugene is about 50 miles south of Portland. Portland would be the main epicenter for all ships entering into port. The skies are blue clear. The sun is bright and shining. A mild wind blowing. Bike paths over there. There's a male, young teenager walking westward, bouncing a basketball. These are the synchronicities with thought, the signs of communication of Mother Nature. I heard the rev of a motor from a car, a V8. A hot rod. Focusing on right brain. We're thinking how to speak our thoughts clearly. Monitoring the root chakra. The source of ascending energy. Relaxed, calm, still, peaceful. We're feeling like a solar panel. Blowing in the breeze. The eyes are open, looking around. Now the eyes are closed. letting the sun shine into our pituitary gland through the eyelids, this thin skin. See, straight ahead is 180 degrees, a right angle is 90 degrees, in between the 180 and the 90 is 45 degrees. And that's where the sun is shining from. Running north and south, up, straight up, is 180. Flat across is 90. And the sun is 45 degrees centered right here. That would be like this. It's exactly where it's at. Forty-five degrees longitude, latitude. It's 12:31 p.m. now, and from 8 to 10 o'clock a.m. is 2 hours of electrical energy. From 10 a.m. to 12 p.m. is magnetic energy. From 12 o'clock to 2 p.m. rotates back to electrical energy. And it fluctuates every 2 hours throughout the day. The electrical energy is the male or causative energy. The magnetic energy is the female. The receptive energy. We are in a causative field right now. According to astrological theory. However, we have the power to co-create our own reality, and we can actually turn or cause any combination of electrical and magnetic energy that we desire. Current positions of the planets and the sun. The sun also being a planet. These are reflective positions. Therefore, when we tap into the Most High, the Holy of Holies, the Ark of the Covenant, when we enter in, where the third eye, the third ear are, we have the power to affect all reflections of our thoughts, reflecting all the planets and the stars around. All the stars are just planets. They're spheres. However, the default mode of the spheres is reflection of all the suns in the universe. Most importantly, the closest sun, which provides the most heat and energy. Twelve to 2 o'clock is electrical energy for the default mode. The breeze is cool. So I'll use thought to warm up the breeze. And we have a helicopter passing overhead. This is a sign of Mother Nature confirming the statements that we just spoke. Although it is a manufactured sign, a manufactured form of communication, the more powerful signs of communication of the universe are living signs, birds, animals, people, wind, trees, sunshine, moonshine, flowers, grass, shrubs, creatures, ants, insects, birds, dogs, bears, lions, tigers, rabbits, frogs, squirrels, babies, teenagers, grandmothers, grandfathers, sons, daughters, presidents, secretaries, police officers, attorneys, lawyers, rangers, these are all living, full capacity, representing the more powerful side of energy known as the male, the electrical. All others that are manufactured through mankind are magnetic. They're reflective. They are the ideas of man, the electrical ideas. Give birth to children through the female, known as Mother Nature. We are sharing our talents freely. As we are connected together, ESP, telepathy, all spirits are joined together now. We are aware of each other. Feet into the slippers. The breeze is cool on the feet. This body weighs 120 pounds. My body has been living on brown rice for 2 weeks. Feeling healthy. Yesterday, this body, our body, ate eggs, cheese, omelets cooked on the stove, 1 dozen eggs throughout the day, actually the day before yesterday. As of now, we are enjoying this wonderful most pleasant state of mind. turn down the fan. There we go. It was rather breezy on the legs. The fan was on high. I was listening to President Obama, his latest video from the White House, entitled Expanding, Take Our Daughters and Sons. To work day. President Obama is doing a wonderful job. Our citizens need jobs and employment, self-employment. And our citizens shall receive these things. Another person on the bike path. A female spoke. That was a sign of Mother Nature. The wind blew the plastic on top of the shed. Plastic is manufactured goods. Another V8 sounding automobile or truck passed by in the west. This way is west. Straight this way is east. This way is south. This way. It's north. Straight up is top. Straight down is bottom. We live on a sphere. The axis of the Earth is at an angle. We will do more studies to find out exactly the angle. Tiny. Tiny's feeling good. Feeling good, huh, Tiny? The rooster just crowed. Confirmation from Mother Nature. We were being nice to Tiny, the cat, who is desiring to morph into a human. Cats are the transitioning of the Tyrannosaurus Rex dinosaurs that lived millions of years ago. We have discovered that this body used to be in the form of a Tyrannosaurus Rex. Top of the chain of command. Top of the flesh-eating food chain. This body's name is Russell. This body, called Russell, loves to shed tears. The syllables of the Rex are tear. Tyrannosaurus. Tyrannosaurus. Another person on the bike path, a mild cough, a sign of Mother Nature. A hen with a quick cackle. Ra, for Russell, Ra is the sun. We'll figure out. L is also the sun. Ra-L, the sun. All names are rooted in the sun. This brain, this body, will absorb knowledge of the Latin language. Introduced through Santos Benaki, whose YouTube channel is Mr. Astrology. This body, Russell, is a centered pure Capricorn, 1 degree right of center. The Capricorn time sign occupies 30 degrees of space. In the center is 15 degrees. The first degree is the month of February, the 23rd day. This body was born on the 9th of January. The 8th day of the month is the center month, designated by 2 spheres with an equator through the center. which represents the dollar sign. Which is backed by Russell's labor through the birth certificate application bond. The cock just crowed. The hen just cackled. The hen cackled again. Birth certificate credit is connected to an ATM card that will manifest so that this body can travel throughout the universe and share knowledge freely with all citizens and freemen. A V8 motor launching, shifting from first to second gear. Sun is now directly behind a branch of the apple tree, casting a shadow across Russell's face. The spirit holds title to this body called Russell. Spirit holds title to Russell's share of the corporate birth certificate application bond, which is connected to all the resources of the earth through a distribution system. One through public money, one through private money. Public money is for citizens. Private money is for title holders, lien claimants, secured party creditors. The hen cackled twice. Birds tweeting, mild automobiles driving by, the sun peeking past the branch, especially when we lift the skull, the head, the cerebrum toward the sun. The feelings of warmth, energy, electrical energy. Reflecting on the body. The body being female. Representing magnetic energy. Magnetic energy is represented by water, earth. Electrical energy is represented through fire and air, air and fire. Earth and water, air and fire. Birds are tweeting. The birds love to tweet during the electrical hours. AM. Is the electrical hours 10 to 12 or 12 to 2 p.m. are also electrical hours. It is currently exactly 1 p.m. It's Thursday. Birds tweeting louder. The wind blowing a little stronger. Peepy the cat. Hep, hep, hep. The birds are engaging. We're communicating. Pitch, the birds are really engaging now. We love to communicate with each other. We have fun. Tiny has lifted the body to sit more on the hot wood. A helicopter in the distance is flying this direction from the southwest. Flying from the southwest, the helicopter. Getting closer. There it is, straight above from southwest, heading toward the Sacred Heart Hospital. It's a blue helicopter with a red light. Sacred Heart Hospital here in Springfield, Oregon, was built in 2000. It is in the northern direction, about 1 mile, 1/2 mile, and we have a nice spider that just crawled on us, a big hairy spider.
Hi, Spidey.
We and the Spideys are friends. We're friends with all the creatures and insects. Birds and squirrels, frogs, possums. Spidey's enjoying the sun. Birds are continuing to tweet. The wind is still at its picked up pace. Coolness running across the body. Another helicopter in the distance. Rather a plane, a jet at high level. Synchronizing with my private thoughts. Spidey just crawled upon the leg, on the shady part of the leg. We're exchanging thoughts. I feel him crawling down the leg, out of the distance, underneath the cover of the edge of the shorts. We have yellow dandelions and white herbs. These are medicine, these right here. I'll let you see. Two birds flying overhead. Very delicious. Fresh dandelion leaf. Nutrients, bitter nutrients. All natural. Another white flower. There's a whole batch of white flowers over there. They look very delicious.
Hi, Tiny. Don't you want some flowers?
Let's see if Tiny likes it.
There you go.
Yep, she likes it. Tiny likes to eat the food that we chew up.
Hi, Tiny. It's good, huh? Real good.
The sun is moving more across the tree branch. Train horn in the distance. my thoughts to help Tiny eat the dandelion. Lick the dandelion. Good, huh, Tiny? Good, huh? Tiny loves to rub noses and mix our nose saliva, trading of the immune systems. And the cock just crowed again. And the bird just tweeted loudly, in synchronization with confirming thoughts. Mother Nature confirming. Cock just crowed again. Bird tweeted loudly. We had thoughts of India. Viewing movies with mother. The international tribal mother. Mother introduces us. We introduce to ourselves through mother. Netflix. Movies of India. We love to sit with mother and listen to her wisdom. The mother of this body, whose name is Sharon. Sharon Ray. The father of this body is Timothy Richard. Sharon and Timothy have made other bodies. Another son and another and a daughter. A son named Jason Adam, and a daughter named Michelle Dawn. Michelle Dawn's husband is Rob. Bob. They have three children, Timmy, Crystal, and Robbie. This body called Russell has two nephews, one niece. Body is referred to as Uncle Russell. Uncle Russell loves his family. He loves his nephews, loves his niece, loves his brother, loves his sister, loves his brother-in-law. And his family, as well as all the family on both sides, mother's side, father's side, Cindy, cousin Jennifer, cousin Richard, cousin Ricky, cousin Mikey. grandmother Florence is 90 years old on mother's side. Quarter Cherokee Indian. Rather, the private side, called the Iroquois. She was married to Freeman. Airplane in the distant sky, low-flying airplane from the local airport, Creswell Airport. Freeman's name is from the lineage of King Henry. The wind blowing stronger. Freeman was in the Air Force. He was a high-level jet mechanic. Florence was a naval wave. Navy. Grandmother June. Russell's father's side was a banker. Russell's grandfather on his father's side, his name was Earl. Supervisor at a oil company in Los Angeles called Baker Oil, Baker Oil Tools. He was in the Army. My mother's sister's name was Stephanie. She married Dean, who is a tax accountant, real estate agent, Mason. Runs a ranch. Man of all trades. Raised horses. Raised cattle. Built houses. He was a state auditor. And mother knows for sure that he was using the 1099 OIDs to live, recycling his money undercover. He lives right down the street from us, Canyonville, Oregon. They had two children, two daughters, Cindy and Jennifer. Cindy went to college, a major in psychology. She married an Indian who runs a facility in California for handicapped children. Children that the state considers handicapped. The children are actually very healthy, needing awareness, special attention, and healing. Jennifer is a school teacher. She married a nice man who is skillful on the guitar. Russell's sister married a man who's the son of a music store owners. Russell's father has two brothers and a sister, Uncle Dave, Uncle Steve, and Aunt Marilyn. Uncle Dave and his wife have two daughters, Kelly and Stacy. Uncle Dave's wife's name is It will arrive. Uncle Dave loves to play guitar and sing. He bought a 12-string guitar when he visited this family when they lived in California in the Bay Area, San Ramon, California. Russell spent time with Uncle Dave visiting one summer and played Uncle Dave's 12-string while Uncle Dave was at work. Uncle Steve's wife is Mary. She's Danish. They have two daughters and a son. Son's name is Kenneth. Kristen, and Dana are the two daughters. Aunt Marilyn, which is Russell's father's sister, married Uncle Mike. They had three sons, Michael, Richard, and see, Ricky. Last I saw him, I was a kid. Ricky, Mikey, and the third one. We just named him earlier. So we have two immediate names to remember. Uncle Dave's wife and the third son of Aunt Marilyn. Birds are tweeting. Junior the cat has arrived, laying on the wood. Vicky, that's her name. Uncle Dave's wife's name is Vicky. Marky, that's his name. The third son, Mark. Mikey's the youngest. Mark's the second. Marky, it was Ricky, Marky, Mikey, or Richard, Mark, Mike, or Michael. Uncle Mike was an entrepreneur, had his own laundry business. Aunt Marilyn was a housewife. Aunt Vicky's a housewife, although she supplemented the income with child care in-house. And Aunt Mary, who was Uncle Steve's wife, whose children were Dana, Christian, and Kenneth, I think she worked for a living. After the children were raised. Uncle Mike had dirt bikes. We visited one summer as young children. We rode the first dirt bike. Russell's body rode this first dirt bike, first and only dirt bike, a small miniature dirt bike. And Russell's body loved it. We loved it. This spirit, the one spirit that is all of us together. We are one spirit. We are also one body. Many different names. The helicopter in the distance again is rising from the hospital. An automobile in the background. It is 1:27, roughly an hour. We'll wait for the helicopter to pass and we will end this video.
How do you do?
This is Junior. And there it's passing, heading mildly southwest. The town on the coast, headed west. Near the ocean is called Florence. The town south of here in Springfield is Cresswell and Drain, and then Canyonville and Medford, Roseburg. Careful, bud. Here you go. Careful. Headed north, we have a city called Cobourg. We also have Salem. Heading east, we have Oak Ridge, Bend, Klamath Falls. We have the Three Sisters Mountains, where provides water for the area that are dammed off. This area here in Springfield, Eugene, used to be a lake.
Like that. Eugene. Careful. Careful.
Junior loves to feel good. Junior. Yes. It is 1:29 p.m. The sun is just about directly overhead, directly south to north. Slightly to the left. And now it's 1:30. So, we shall record again. Enjoyed each other's presence.